fancy farm. I'm so happy to be with you here today. I want to thank the Father, Bishop Medley, Father Brenters, Steve Elders, Mark Wilson. But the one thing that I want to make sure that you all do before you leave today is thank one of the volunteers that are working in all of these booths. Think about that. All of these people are here as volunteers, so thank all the volunteers today. As you walk around these picnic grounds today, you will see families. These are families that are almost at the end of their summer break. What they're getting ready to do is go back to school. There's a lot of kids excited to go back to school. There's a lot of teachers excited. Guess what? Not all kids are excited to go back to school, and there's some parents that are absolutely dreading it. Our kids depend on their teachers and their parents to celebrate their successes and also be there with them for their frustrations. But there's another group out there that the kids really need. They need the voters' vote for yes on Second Amendment in November. The future of education depends on it. It can be the freedom for every child to strive. Not just the rich kids, but every child, the voiceless, the parents that don't have anything that they can do to have a choice. And several ask, why would we ever do an amendment? Well, quite frankly, I have to admit I'm a little selfish on it. If we didn't have things like amendments, most of you all, half of you at least, including myself, would not be allowed to vote. So when you think about amendments, why we change it, our founding father, one of them, Thomas Jefferson, his quote, "I am an advocate for frequent change in laws and constitutions, but laws and constitutions must go hand in hand with the progress of the human mind." We no longer have a one-room school anymore. We are trying to teach these kids globally, and we want to make sure they can compete. The future is ahead of us if you believe that. And if we don't pay closer attention, half of our kids in the state of Kentucky cannot read at grade level. That's an embarrassment, A third of them are not proficient in math. We have done altogether over record funding, even accounting inflations, $17,000, over $17,000 for every single child in the system. And you know what that's got us? 38th in the nation. That is so embarrassing. Not only are we advocating today for the freedom of kids on Second Amendment to have a voice in their education with their families, it's just really sad to think all of our neighboring states have left us behind. All of our neighboring states, and here we are, trailing at the bottom. It has helped so many other states. They want to say it'll harm public education. It may harm the systems, but it will not harm the teachers and the public education for every single child out there. If you truly believe that children are the future of Kentucky, if you truly think that they are, by gosh, they're worth it. They are worth your vote, the Second Amendment in November. This is a vote yes on Second Amendment for education freedom. Our future is worth it. Our future depends on it. Our children are worth it. So love that child. Every child is worth it. Vote yes on Second Amendment. And don't forget, share it and check out the priest before you leave.